First up, let me talk to you about margins itself, because the quarter has been good, but with the kind of movement that we're seeing now in crude, what is the outlook for FY19?
Thank you for having me. The outlook is pretty good. I think what is coming off in the numbers is essentially the backdrop of what's happened post GST. So we expected volumes to actually spurt up post GST. We had a little bit of a dip post July, but then it started moving up and we've seen this growth continuously. There are several aspects to it. So there is an element of perhaps some movement from the unorganized sector to the organized sector. There's also a demand for supply chain kind of services. We've added a capacity in terms of ships, so that's added in terms of growth. Clearly, things like the impact of crude does have an impact. 40 to 50% of our operating cost is fuel. However, we have back-to-back contracts with our clients where we actually have fuel escalation contracts and we pass on that fuel increase. So there is certainly a top-line increase. There's an impact of that and consequently some impact on the bottom line as well. But it's really net off at the end of it.
Okay. Vineet, if I look at your Seaways segment, that's actually outperformed the other two segments. I know it's on a low base, but nonetheless, you have your revenue, which has risen 61%. Your margins have improved quite significantly to 31%. What does this comprise of? What's led to this revenue growth and what can we expect?
So the Seaways business essentially operates two ships on the west coast of India, from Mundra to Cochin. Mm-hmm. And these are container ships. And three ships on the east coast of India, which is from Chennai to Port Blair. And essentially, we added this new capacity on the western coast very early in this year and in the last financial year, rather. And that has started to give volume growth as well as growth in terms of profitability. Mm-hmm. So we do expect this to continue. We, in fact, actually bought one more ship in March 18, and that is going to start coming into operation by the end of the first quarter. And that will further contribute to growth in this division. The CAPEX plan for this division is to add a ship every approximately 12 to 18 months. And so this is essentially for the coast of India. As you know, that multimodal is growing in India. The cargo needs to move not just on road, move away from road rather to rail as well as sea. And the government has a big thrust on this with the Bharatmala project and several such projects. So we see a good growth opportunity to provide a seamless linkage between road, rail and sea.
That makes sense, actually. And, you know, I want to just focus on the Seaways business a little bit more, because this is the highest margin business and by far, right? In terms of revenue, how much would each ship incrementally add? I mean, from the current 10% contribution, how much would you scale it up, like, say, in the next 2 or 3 years?
So each ship depends upon the capacity of the ship. The newest ship that we added is our largest ship with a 700 TEU capacity. 20 feet container capacity, and that should add to about another approximately 60-70 crores to about 80 crores in revenues for this financial year. However, the growth of the other divisions, since they are larger, it will be also there in terms of 10 to 20%. So the net contribution of this division should remain between this 10 and 15%. It will not significantly scale up.
Okay. What is your presence in the e-commerce segment when it comes to logistics, and what is the kind of upscale or scale up that we could see in that?
So that's very interesting. We actually do a lot of fulfillment for e-commerce customers. Fulfillment means at the back end we run warehouses for them where we do the complete order processing. So if you're a customer who gives an order to one of the e-commerce guys, the order actually comes to our warehouse where we start the processing of the order. So we'll pick the order, we'll pack it, we'll invoice it, and we'll keep it ready for shipment. Okay. And the scalability there is massive, because each warehouse that we create for a client could be between 25 to 60,000 orders a day. So we've added several of these facilities in the last few years. And that's one part of it, but there are also certain customers, like the retail customers, who are actually adding an e-commerce line to their business. Mm. So instead of not just delivering to their stores, we are also delivering to the e-commerce customers. So doing the back-end fulfillment for them as well. So we do see a lot of growth in this area in the next few years.
Okay, just one last question then on the two board decisions this time around. One is you're moving your cold chain unit out of this company itself. And the second is this SCM log focus. What's the rationale there?
So that's just a subsidiary company that we created where we will move the cold chain division to a subsidiary. So it's
you're
just,
not hiving it off. You're not
no,
selling
it's not,
it.
No, okay. It's not selling it. It's just a simple subsidiarization.
And SCM lock focus?
It's just a shell company that was acquired to merge, put that entity into that.